Alright, we're on CP Snakewater. And we're playing with Kev. He is on medic. And we're just rolling out. This guy tries to kick me right away. Maybe I killed him in the last game. Not really sure, maybe for the memes. I don't think it was for the reason this guy said. Luckily the vote fails, we can just focus on the game. I like to take height top left here and do fade bombs. I see this spy on our medic and I wanted to back them up, jump over to the pack. Here I'm throwing down some rockets, get that demo kill. I see that this soldier was kind of botting forward. I'm getting hit from right above. The guy drops down as I jump away. Clean up the pyro. We still have that spy. I don't know if I just took my lost track of them, but I probably should have helped clean up that spy. But we're rolling. This guy miss. He's just jumping around. A little sloppy there, but no big deal. Now I just want to get on anybody that I see in, but I, you know, don't want to overcommit and leave my medic alone. We should be pressing forward. I see that guy got out. Oh wow! Just as I'm about to jump to take bats, these guys just pour out. They're down a bunch. So I'm really would like to bully our way in. This is a great entrance here. Is lower. They're down a ton of people. Missed that shot. I'm just going to shoot a few rockets behind just in case he wants to press forward and try to clean up on that damage. Our team's super slow. We missed our opportunity where they were down everybody and now they're getting up. And yeah, that's just, you know, when there's got to be some urgency on a team when they're down 6 or 7, you know what I mean? That's such a huge opportunity. Yeah, there's going to be a couple people to defend, but it's not like, you know, when their whole team gets up and their spawn is at last, that's when really you need to try to make a play. So this is, I'm just getting on the point. I'm just hoping I can get some cap time, rally our team. I'm drawing all of them to the point, and our team doesn't get in. And this is very, I mean, this is like the theme of like so many of our videos. Casual players, they don't necessarily know like those flags to go off to commit to things. I think the better you get, the more you kind of start to realize that there's bigger plays available than any one single kill. And yeah. Okay, here I clean up the scout. I want to kill this sentry, but this pyro is looking at me. And unfortunately, he air blasts. I thought I was outside of his range, but pyro gets an insane cone to reflect. And it's a broken class. And then there's random crits. So a little bit jaded from that. But I get a nice little reward here for rolling out and get this pyro. They're down 3, not that many, so we're looking for picks now. We're looking for kills, looking to find spaces that are available where we can pop in and get these sentry kills. Here I threw 3 rockets and then they pull up in the, I can't remember that. 2 good, really good kills. The Wrangler. Oh man, I was about to jump in after I hit that, but my accuracy was just a little off. But again, I feel like you can kind of see it, like I'm the only one even attempting to cap the point. I thought I heard a pyro, and I know rolling out last time there was a pyro that just went like lower to behind. So I thought maybe I was gonna look around and find one. Our medic called and I lost them. I don't know. I think Kev is playing with the rest of the team more so than trying to play with me. But we do connect. And I see this gun. That's a huge thing I want to do, is get this gun. Unfortunately, We just get air blasted around. They're down a ton of people. The rest of our team got it. Like, look at this. They're five people up. Everybody flood in. Go, go, go. Gotta get the sentry. Got it. Get on the point. I'm gonna take height because I'm assuming the scout was gonna get on to start the cap. And that way I don't have to sacrifice myself and I can still get some good kills with my explosive damage. There we go. We clean up everyone except for one person. And then we're gonna look for them. Boom. There we go. We got everybody. Still a great game though. And yeah, it's just Snakewater Last is such a hard one to crack. Sometimes on Snakewater Last, one of our strategies was to pull people out on the second. So we'd kind of back up or we'd go for a higher, like sack two or three. That way it kind of forces them to try to push out on the second. And then if we ever won that fight, that refight, we'd pretty much win the round. So it was a way to kind of crack the defense. Here I'm just bopping around. I'm not trying to take the pack just so other people on our team have access to it. I see that heavy coming across. Now I'm kind of pushing down. There's a pack that I saved. And I'm backing off. We have way too many people down. I'm going to call for medic and jump rotate over to Saw because that's where I assumed their heavy combo was going to switch over to. But we take this space. I can hear the fighting going lower, so I want to just try to get some free picks if I can. And there we go. We got a great med kill. They're capping second. I kill the spy who's trying to get on our medic. Lots of damage was already done to those guys, so easy cleanup kills, even though they were a quick fix. I have three ammo, so I'm thinking about ammo. As long as I don't step outside here and take a crit to the face, I'll be fine. Next video I'm going to do is going to be like, every time I die to random crits. I think there's already been two opportunities for something, for clips here. But then, you know, then I could do like a crits compilation of me getting crits. Man, I've definitely dealt my share of crits to people. Here these guys are focusing me. I'm just going to guess this guy, the soldier's going to jump up. And yes, there you go, he does. And he sort of commits. He's got shotgun, so he's not really able to jump. Easy kill there. I hear the sentry, so I don't necessarily want to fully commit into this point. I think the sentry is lower just based on how it was sounding. Another good kind of tip is like, okay, your teammate, you're not, the teammates you're communicating lower, you could just watch the kill cam to see if they get a sentry. But I'm being very cautious because I feel like I should have seen a sentry. We ended up getting a little flank on their team that was trying to push in through our kitchen. I see two other players. Instead of capping, I'm gonna go for some damage on these flank players. This NG, dead to rights, sniper, good cleanup kills. They're six up, so every one of us should try to get in. I think I'm calling for medic because I want to get in lower again. These guys aren't looking at us. Two really good picks. We're trying to get in through lower. Just dodge the huntsman. For the love of God. Two rockets on the huntsman. Didn't kill him. Very surprising. But I'm going to start the cap. This should be enough to rally our team. Unfortunately, went down there to the huntsman. And the rest of our team. Looks like they weren't able to get in either. Or they weren't able to get much. So very similar to last round. But I think we can definitely do this. I cut across because I want to take height now. I love this spot right here. This is like my favorite spot to defend from because I just am so like, I'm doting over everybody. They have to address me. I'm getting like maximum damage. Okay, now we're getting pressure from lower. We're getting pressure from all three angles. This soldier specifically is looking at me. I could tell he's tracking me. He's only looking at me. And unfortunately get air shot. He says, I wish I clipped that. It was a good shot. I haven't been double air shot since invite, so it's nice to see that other members of the community are working on their DM. I think I play a little differently when I'm playing against really good players. I won't just... I'll, like, throw in wiggles, and, like, I'll throw in fades. So now that I know this player has the potential to hit air shots, I will approach him differently. So that's one of the things I always consider. Here I'm completely kind of overrun, and our medic bailed out, which is understandable because we were just overrun completely. I don't know where the rest of our team is. I think that's one of the biggest flaws on our team, is they just don't know how to... Okay, Kev looked like a spy there. I don't know, they just don't know how to get in on spots. Even though, yeah, we're up against some resistance, it's like, let's get in. Now, I will say that demo... That demo is got some cojones. Same situation. See how I threw in a way, like a back fade, and I didn't ever kind of give that guy another opportunity to get the same sort of air shot? That's exactly what I mean. You know, as I figure out the skill level, I'll kind of adjust my play. This guy says he misses the sweaty spaghetti frisbee, and I said so do I. Shout out to Sweaty Spaghetti. That was the name of the team I started when I first joined competitive. And we went... I think we won like 20-some games in a row. 20-some matches in a row. Our first loss we got was in like playoffs and amateur on the second season of us playing. We clean up that soldier that had the good DM. Get some good kills. I'm just trying to shoot people that aren't in the Uber and pop them up and force them to have to deal with their consequences of their decisions. Good easy pick. I only had to shoot two because I didn't see the NG, but I just wanted to make sure that sentry was going to go down, because that's going to really dictate my next play here. And then I wanted to come back and just see, are any other players on, you know, our other guys. Oh, God. That guy definitely does some MGE or something. Because those rockets would have hit. That definitely would have hit if I didn't get the hell out of the way of that. I can't believe that demo didn't back off. Got hit two rockets. He's like, I'm gonna keep going. Just probing. At this point, we're down three, so I think it's better to look for picks, even the playing field. You know, draw them out. I think that's that good soldier. And I was going to hold height on him. There, I missed the rocket jump on that little sliver of platform. Which, it's a hard jump to make sure you hit that. I hear a lot of, like, fighting going on, and I don't know where it's happening. Here I miss one shot on that demo. Unfortunately, hit the sliver of, the sliver of the doorway. I feel like he kept trying to shoot at me, though. I was pretty impressed. I see two snipers top left, so now I want to take heals lower. Ideally, I want to get Uber and go in through lower. That worked the last time. Easy kill on this demo. Just pop them up. If you're ever facing a demo, just shoot at their feet, pop them up, and just bounce them around. There, we get the sentry right away. This guy, they get some really good kills on me, but we drew them all to the point, and I think... Yep, our team is finally flooding in, and we get the win. GG's. That was kind of a quick one. So I'm going to show one more game. Okay, we are on CP process. We just joined in. Looks like it's been going for just a little bit. We came out, we saw that spy playing rock, paper, scissors. We don't want to interrupt those things. Those are sacred events. I take height. I guess I didn't realize this demo was gonna keep targeting me. Kind of in continuation to... I think I'm doing like a jeers to that NG because he hasn't moved up. But, yeah, oh, that's another thing. The Telly took us backwards. That was so lame. This NG's like taking our players backwards on purpose. But, whatever. Scrubs are gonna scrub. Here, I'm getting shot at. Try to get that scout out of the air. I missed it. He was on fire and I still put down like 30 or 40 damage. There, I got pre-fired by a sticky. That was weird. But maybe he was just trying to get those stickies down. So maybe it's not that sus. Good cleanup kill on Scrappy. I think this pack was just taken. The timing for it was, I kept thinking, I'm like, wow, this pack isn't up yet. But we find a medic, which is actually great. This is going to give us the overheals we need to kind of get in, put some pressure down on this sniper. They're already trying to cap on mid, so I think it's good to get a to get some cap time. Everybody comes back. We are in trouble. Med doesn't make it. I'm getting hunted. I just try to throw rockets down so I can get across this open field. I see three units on the point, or three enemies. I'm going to put a rocket down. That way our pyro, who was flanking in, at least has maybe a chance to turn some heads and not get taken out. They use. I see this scout on the left. I'm just throwing down some fire in prediction. I'm now on fire. I get the pack, and I'm kind of trying to figure out what my next move is. We clean up this pyro. And we do some damage to their med, so if I can get some overheals, I'll bust in and make some space for everyone. Scout flanks us. Nobody gets any damage on him. Doesn't feel like anybody's paying attention. That medic missed three arrows. Four. Hey, there you go. This heavy, I luckily had a little cover there behind that box to attempt to do a little flank. And it's great because we ended up doing some really good damage. That demo overcommitted. I'm gonna try to take height, and man, missed my second rocket. Took out, got headshot by a sniper. I was hoping to get that that air shot. Oh, I see Kev, another terrible teleporter. At this point, I actually kind of want to vote kick that person, but they do have a nice sentry and last. I just feel like they had too many strikes with me where they're like. Nice arrow from Kev. There we go. Now we got a real medic. This guy is just using the soda popper. There's a heavy in here. Get out. Get out if you can. That would have been a great time to use to save Kev, Toxic Child, and then he just drops. I have no confidence in that medic, that other medic. So it's really just me and Kev on our own. Okay, so now we're kind of losing this. Which I actually kind of like, because that means we're up against a great challenge. Kev's on medic, so I know we're up to the challenge. Get a nice pick on that pyro. These guys are in, so I'm gonna bomb across and try to help anyone playing at 5. Get a nice cleanup kill on that scout. See this other scout. Clean him up. This pyro, or this demo is like missing all the shots on me. I'm just waiting for these sticky to be blown up. Jesus, we get a nice kill on that heavy. I'm actually going to jump back and see if I need to get on this. Oh, yeah, they got it through the left. Good rocket on that med. We clean them up. Let's get out. I'm focusing on getting heals and getting out of this choke point. It's so hard to fight your way out of second. But with heals, especially with quick fix and a couple picks like we had, we can do it. Just got to really have to put pressure on the sniper to get everybody out the door. I don't want Kev to die. I don't want any of my medics to die to these snipers, but Toxic Child, again, just not doing anything to try to prevent his death. Oh, man. I am just getting beaten around. Just before that demo can shoot at me, he gets removed from match by system. So I kind of get a free one there. Now I'm behind. I heard their soldier rolling out. I'm just looking to get pack and play their spawn. I'd like to play with Kev, but I just got caught behind, so I need to make the most of it. And preventing them from rolling out is huge. That's like, can add so much value. This demo tries to hide in that little crevice. Get a med kill, that's huge. Now these guys don't have heals, only three up, and they lost second. They're only two up, huge jump. They got a ton of spawners before we could get heals. I'm gonna land on their pack, and I'm just gonna try to draw them back. I have 30 health, and I'm on fire. As long as I can get to this pack in sewer, I might have a chance. I get put on fire again. They just spawn five at the spawn point on second, because we have second capped. I want to see if I can go lower and just avoid everybody. None of them really saw me, so I think I'm fine. One spawner. It's a spy. I heard their shutter door open, so I'm just going to assume a spy went one. Quickly make up my way to the pack. They have three spawners plus one spy out looking for me. There he is. He's dead. I have 125 health. So taking on this pyro that just spawned might be tricky. I don't like that fight. I don't like that fight, so I backed off. Because I know they're going to have other spawners. It just could be too much for me. But I jump in, I get back to the fight, and fortunately, uneven ground, I try to C-tap and I miss the jump. It's just a bummer. Here, I take the telly. On to second, get two good cleanup kills. I'm looking to jump to choke now. It'd be cool if we can get through choke and end this game. Take height. I see two medics. They're not with anybody, but I want to get on this sniper so he can stop kind of killing our team from afar. He jukes me. He jukes me and then congas. That's a huge move. I get back through choke. I see two players in our IT. Putting down a lot of pressure. I avoid this spy, luckily. I'm gonna let him go because we want to take out that combo. Take height. Waiting for this soldier to bomb, but I don't feel like he ever got his jump off. Pressure out that all their players. And I actually ran out of ammo. I don't know how I keep running out of ammo. Alert. The control point is being captured. We get through on second, and instead of kind of shooting the obvious things, I kind of pressure them right at the chokes. Oh man, I get just face stabbed, and then I kill myself with my own damage. I don't know where our players are, but just rolling out. I'm gonna jump the point. Scout gets on it, and we get the cap. That was a good first round. Okay, we're on the second round here. Got Kev on quick fix. Hit my rollout. Let's just see if we can roll out with him. I guess we disconnected just before. And then Kev's healing another soldier, but I don't know if that soldier knows to jump up because he has quick fix. And now they all rolled out IT, but we're all here, so putting tons and tons of span on IT and then forcing them not to get in. That's a huge mistake. That's a big mistake on them to send so many people through IT, because if a soldier rolls up fast, it's going to be immediate, like too much pressure to even bust through. We take out that sentry. I think if I was looking back on this, I should have jumped to that sniper in the far back to put immediate pressure down and to go behind. And yep, I finally do it. I duck into rollout. I see this soldier. He had a cool hat on, so I assumed he was gonna be better than the average bear, but he's just spamming me from afar. I connect with our other medic who doesn't really have but he's playing with this other pyro, and I'm now helping spawn camp. I see that they're on that door, so I'm going to go back and try to help the other fight, try to get involved, because we don't need everybody spawn camping. especially when we are having trouble getting on a second. Take out that mini. I'm gonna jump on a point, start the cap. They're probably all fighting on mid right now, so this is just a perfect time to back cap. This medic sees what's happening, but there's no way this medic could ever beat me, especially on low ground and getting shot a bunch. Yeah, they were capping mid, so we got the back cap, and this sentry was coming up. That would have been cool if I got that air shot, but we still got the win. Yeah, pretty good games. Appreciate the heals from Kev. Cool. All right, GG's.